don't take off their sisters, their dead sister's leather jacket. When I heard it, a loud crack from the bathroom. Every muscle in my body froze. Two boys walked in. Then there'd be a paper bag on my head. Wait, is that an expression? Hey guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel.
Stranger.
So today's video I'm actually so excited for because I'm going to be reading the stories I used to write when I was in like fifth grade for you guys. I found these all on my Google Drive recently and they're actually so entertaining. Basically, for some context, when I was little, I was like, oh my gosh, I'm gonna be an author when I grow up, haha. Which honestly, like, I am a good writer. These are kind of good. Like, I kind of popped off with my writing, but also when I was little, I read so much and I was obsessed with Percy Jackson and the Harry Potter series, and I straight up just copied the storylines. Anyways, let's just hop right into it. I'm genuinely scared. Let's just start with the knockoff Percy Jackson one because it's one of my faves. Okay, this series was basically Percy Jackson, but not, as I said, and the main character was called Stella Robinson. Ooh. Guys, I found my old sketchbook where I've sketched pictures of it, so I'll put a close-up of what I thought she was gonna look like. And I think this was supposed to be the book cover. Oh my gosh, I'm cringing so bad. I can't do it. Okay. The minute my parents decided to send me to boarding school in New Jersey, I knew something was up. For one thing, my parents hated boarding schools almost as much as me. And for another thing, my mom was so overprotective that I couldn't ride the bus to school alone. So why was I traveling over 1,000 miles by myself to Richard Jameson Academy? Ooh, I like that name. My Aunt Lydia said they had a change of heart. I thought change of hearts were supposed to be good, I retorted. She smirked. I think this is. Troubled teenage girls who don't take off their dead sister's leather jacket belong somewhere other than here. Richard Jameson's is the perfect place for you. The troubled teenage girl stormed out of the room after that. Okay. I went out of my way to make sure my parents I knew I hated their choices. I mean, my life wasn't perfect here in Rocky Falls, but at least I had a family and one friend. So I sulked around the whole time before I had to leave, didn't pack, and sang, I'm going to my doom all the way to the airport. Unfortunately, I still had to go. You're the worst parents ever, I shouted to my two-person farewell committee as I boarded the plane. My mom smiled sweetly and waved. My father didn't even look up from the newspaper he's reading. Gosh. Oh, I think where I was going with this, they're like enchanted, like mind controlled, because like they actually do love her, but they're like being controlled or something. The second I was at Richard's, I was thrown into a desk and forced to study. That's where I was when I heard it. A loud crack from the bathroom. Looking around, no one else seemed to have heard it. It was only my overactive imagination, I told myself, and tried to concentrate on Marco Polo's trip to China. However, 5 minutes later, there was another noise, identical to the first, except for the fact that it was followed by a smaller snap. Ew. The room was still unperturbed. That's a big word. Dang. How did I have such good vocabulary? Anyways. Still, I knew it wasn't in my head this time. Taking a look won't hurt anything, right? Boy, was I wrong. Mr. Shores, can I go to the bathroom? Go ahead, Stella, but be quick. I hurried out into the hall and into the bathroom. The noises were coming from the fourth stall. I walked up to it and opened the door carefully. Every muscle in my body froze. My brain screamed, no, no. Nothing could have prepared me for what I saw. A huge, aggressive-looking green dragon stood there. Aggressive is not a good adjective for that. Okay. Anyways, right in front of me. Stella Robinson, I've been waiting, it hissed. I froze. My whole brain shrieked run, but I held my ground and rolled my eyes, trying to keep calm. Why won't you run, honey? Just run. Judging by the looks of this bathroom, a long time. I gestured to the torn blanks planks of wood and ripped off toilet seat. It snarled. Was that an insult, weakling half fairy? Instead of half blood in Percy Jackson, it's a half fairy. I'm so cringed out. Anyways, yes, that was you. I racked my brain, which had thankfully started working again. Green giant, said a voice behind me. Two boys walked in. Just by looking at them, you could tell these weren't ordinary boys. The polished shorts that hung at their waists, and the nonchalant expressions they wore as they stared into the dragon's hypnotic eyes kind of gave it away. The first one, who had thought up the dragon insult, stepped forward and started jabbing the dragon with his sword. I guess he was trying to look heroic. Only problem was, he was super bad. I didn't really have much knowledge in that area of subject. That's definitely not right. But if I were his sword play teacher, there'd be a paper bag on my head. Wait, is that an expression? Did I just make that up, or is that supposed to be an expression or something? Let me look this up. Okay, update. I literally have no idea what I was trying to say there, because none of the meanings matched what I think I was trying to say. Nah, I don't know what was going on there. Anyways, a dragon claw swiped at his arm. If the dude's trying to save us, he's only making it worse, I thought. And then instinct took over. I grabbed his sword and started sparring with the dragon myself. Swordplay is way harder than it looks. Man, did I find that out the hard way. Trying to maintain the weight of your sword while still stabbing something is ridiculously difficult. I wouldn't know, I've literally never done that in my life. But anyways, fortunately I was able to get one good blow in. The dragon started limping. A few seconds later, it fell to the ground. From one blow? Okay. Woohoo, I thought as a tidal wave of relief washed over me. I just killed a dragon. Then I realized that its chest was moving up and down. Well, knocked out a dragon. The other boy must have realized that the beast was still alive too, because he said, "We should get out of here, it'll wake up soon." I nodded in agreement and awkwardly gave the sword back to the first guy. "Let's get out of here." They started walking out the door. When they said they had to pick up one more person, I thought Alex and Clayton knew who they were looking for. Wow, that was absolutely zero context. There needs to be a whole nother paragraph of introductions that went on there, but no, okay. I stood mistaken. Her name, April Green, and her school was all that we knew about her. If you guys don't know, this is literally like Percy Jackson. They go to the school to try and find the half-blood. "How will you tell who she is?" I whispered. We were crouched behind some thorny bushes lining the area of a school courtyard. About 1,000 girls wandered around. "I'm thinking her," said Clayton softly. He pointed to a dark-haired girl in the center of a mob. "She looks strong and capable. I sincerely hoped she was April." "Still, how do you know?" I said. "You're going to find out," replied Alex from behind me. He pushed me into the clearing. I stuck my head back in. "What do I do?" He rolled his eyes. "Ask." Okay, what I want to know is which of these boys was going to be the love interest, because one of them has to be. Comment down below. Let's make a love triangle. Team Alex or Team Clayton? I stumbled around until I found a nice-looking girl. "I'm looking for April. April Green?" She pointed towards the mob. I pushed through the crowd. Finally, I reached the center. "Are you April Green?" I asked the dark-haired girl. She wrinkled her nose. I could have sworn a puff of smoke came out of it. "No, she is." I followed her finger to a blonde girl leaning against the fence. Reading. Oh, wrote that twice. Cute. A book the size of me. "Her?" I ran over to the girl. "April, you've got to come with me." She frowned. "Why?" "Because I have your binder," I said, making stuff up wildly. "It's over in the bushes." She raised an eyebrow. "Okay, why did she believe that? That's the dumbest excuse ever." I led her over to the bushes. Alex eyed her. "You sure it's her?" Positive. "Yeah, how many April Greens do you think there are, Alex?" Okay, anyways. April crossed her arms. "What's going on? Why do I need to go with you?" I looked down at my feet. I couldn't fully answer that question yet. I didn't really know. "Yeah, you just went with two random boys who have swords and didn't tell you anything. That makes no sense. Come on, Stella. Get your head in the game. These could be kidnappers." Anyways. Then a roar erupted from the courtyard. I could hear girls screaming behind me. "That's why," Clayton said worriedly. Stella, you better see this. I turned around and gasped. The dark-haired girl had disappeared. In her place was the dragon. It growled, Stella Robinson, you will not escape me a second time. That was in all caps. I gulped and faced Alex and Clayton. What do we do now? Run. And that's where it ends. Okay, review time. So, honestly, my storytelling skills pretty good, guys. Like, I popped off, considering this was, what, 2014? But the plot was unoriginal, and I really didn't know where I was going with it, you know? Okay, so then I had to go do something, and I forgot to end this, but basically, let's do final thoughts. So, the writing, pretty good. Storyline, so many plot holes, does not make sense, and is unoriginal, but overall, it was okay. Have more, but reading them took longer than I expected, so comment down below if you want a part 2, 3, 4, whatever, and yeah, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you in my next video.